are in the first Badger semifinal. Yutian Wang with the serve in game one, best of seven. Got a problem to score 4-2. Excellent forehand block. This is a new player, Li Fu. I think he's playing out of Mississippi now, and clearly 26-something. Jishan Liang, the defending champion, is in the semifinals of the other half against Tong Zong. Excellent. Lou picked that up. Look at that, folks. That was sweet. Let that ball fall down low, and Yutian, three beautiful loops. One, two, three, third one. Nice hook down the line. Doesn't get much better than that. Side under serve, driving a little bit long. Excellent 1-2 backhand. Backhand opening on the serve and then getting up tall and getting on top of that second backhand. It's not easy to do. Wang is, Yutian is pretty tall. Excellent return to serve there. Dead ball serve, and he just came in and flicked it quick. A stellar first game by Yutian Wang. He looks like he wants to win that $3,000. Li Fu, not very competitive. A new player, we don't know how strong this Li is. Who did he beat on the way in? He beat his teammate, Chen Wei Sun. Then he beat Bo Wen Chen from Maryland. So Bo's a solid 25-50 player. Came all the way from Maryland, got knocked out in the quarters. ...217 players in this Butterfly-sponsored tournament. Right now, they're in the 2,300 round robins. Playing events every 3 hours with the Omnipong, and it's been scheduled pretty darn good. 49 tables in action. Second game coming up. Prize is $3,000 for the winner, $1,500 runner-up, $750 semifinalist. Loser of this will get $750. Prize money in table tennis is not really grown in 20 years or so. Doesn't seem to be a real priority in U.S. table tennis, and I know a lot of people think that this can never work, but if you don't have prize money, you're always going to be small. If you don't have a path to professionalism, you're guaranteed to be a small sport. So if that's not going to be your priority, then you're saying that you'll be a small sport forever, and I think table tennis deserves better. I mean, If the goal was proper and people were really working for it, there'd be no reason why Las Vegas national champion wouldn't be getting $25,000 for first. And that would be the appropriate prize. Not $3,500. 2-3. Lee set to receive deep in the backhand corner. Nice return. He's pretty light on his feet. Never seen him play before, but he sure was impressive in the quarters and the early round robins. Nothing ball serve, flip by Yutian, but a little too slow. When you serve that nothing ball and you're looking for the flip, it's pretty vulnerable. You can really put it away like Lee did there. Looks to me like Lee has pips on his backhand or something. I saw the ball coming off kind of funny off that side. There's an instance right there where Lee stepped in way too early. The most important thing when you return serve is stay neutral. Don't guess. Stay neutral. Make one good positive move, decisive move, and then go do it. Too often people are stepping in and the ball's deep. Beautiful return there. Laid the wrist back and then flipped it to the corner. When your opponent's expecting an underspin return and you turn it into topspin, it's so hard to regroup to get on top of that ball when you're expecting to come up under it. Well, there's that push with no spin. No spin can be very valuable because when a player opens up on no spin, it's hard to get a lot of rotation, so the counter loop can be pretty secure or consistent. And those pips are so vulnerable, though. They're so limited. He's got the, I want to see if he, what he can do on the backhand. He hasn't really done anything with the backhand. No power blocks or power counters. Let's see if he gets something done. Just pushes. Yeah. Big game. Second game. There's a good shot there where the pips kind of scored the point. When you counter with the pips, it's dead and it floats a little. The problem is it's a little vulnerable because it's not moving forward like a topspin ball. Wow, three errors in a row just when he looked like he was going to go up 2-0. Make it four. Four errors in a row. Excellent controlled block by Lee. But he hasn't done much these last 4 points. He just kept it in play and got a couple errors off the pips. Could turn this match right around, right here. Five in a row. The ups and downs of ping pong. Up 1-0, 8-6, and then lose five in a row. And you're back to 1-1 instead of 2-0. The South Shore Sports, October 22 and 23 in Highland, Indiana. Major tournament coming up in October. October 22 and 23. And also, I've written a book. This is Dan Seemiller. I wrote a book, Revelations of a Table Tennis Champion, which is out on Amazon.com and has 100 photos and a couple hundred pages, and it's a pretty good story about table tennis. I know it's about me, but I think you would enjoy it. I'm pretty proud of it. Just came out this week. One game each in the Butterfly Badger Open. Fighting for the $3,000 prize. Jorge Ivan against the umpire. Just getting back in his chair. Deep serve, heavy side under. Side top. Difficult to find that pip counter drive on the backhand. That ball, you have to wait a little bit. You got to move up a little bit. It's not going to reach you. You have to open your racket a little bit because it's going to be dead ball. Nice little dead ball there coming into the pips. Anytime you play long pips or short pips, dead balls into that side, very little friction, difficult for them to control the ball. Oh, that was ugly. There, he's trying to go for a short banana flip, but the ball was deep and got cut, swinging early. You always have to be ready for the fast serve when you're receiving. You don't have a lot of time on that one. And if you're ready, you can make them pay. Both these guys are pretty loose on their half-long serves, letting them open up. Lee's looking for another rally here in game three. He hasn't really played well this whole match. He just had a nice little streak at the end of game two. And missing easy balls like that. Wong has that nice backhand opening. I do have to say, I don't think there's any possibility you can see that serve being hit on contact. The shoulder's completely hiding the ball, but nobody on the top of these players all serve that way, so they don't say anything. Two games to one. Li Pu hasn't shown a lot. You know, he has those pips on the backhand on the red side and then inverted on the forehand. And what you get there is kind of two different balls. One's a heavy topspin. The other one's going to be sort of, you know, a no-spin sort of straight ball. A Nice little drop on the serve, a little bit high, but counter loop goes long. Coming up next in the second semifinal, Jishan Liang from the Triangle Table Tennis Club these days. Nice pickup off the pips, and down the line it goes. Li Pu down the line with the pips. Excellent play. Jishan Liang against Tong Zeng from Mississippi College. The other semifinals. Side top. Good return by Li. Jamming him in the middle, a little bit backhand middle. And a 5-1 start for the newcomer. Sweet. Couple nice backhand counter drives and pick up the forehand counter loop right off the bounce. Another good opening. When you're looping those underspins, folks, let them fall and get down low and spin them from a lower arc and get that ball arcing over the net. That way the re-loop very difficult. Deep, heavy underspin there. Strong play out of the backhand this game. He's really turned it around. This is the first game that Li Pu has really played with using his techniques. And a quick 9-3 lead, and looks like it's gonna go maybe 7, folks. It's going 6 for sure. Yep, it's going 6 for sure. We're gonna be 2-2. These are tough technical matches, you know. Who's gonna make the adjustment? What serve should we use? Excellent play there by Li Pu. He made adjustments there and dominated that game 11-3. First game, though, that he really showed like he was in control. And Yutian just bad start and really didn't do much there. Jishan's over there telling him, he's his coach. It looks like he's telling him you need to use your backhand a little bit more aggressive. The winner of this match moves into the final, semifinal. Some 60 players entered the open singles. Now they're down to 4. I lost earlier today. I beat Gabriel Skolnick in the group, which wasn't too bad. And then Cheng Li from Mississippi College. I had 3-0 and 10-9. Lost the game. Lost the fifth. And then had 10-9 again in the sixth. Lost the game. And lost the seventh, 11-9. Pretty much makes me want to puke. All right, 2-2. Boy, Li has really turned it up. Excellent play the last 20 points or so. Just totally different player. Technique better. Look at that. Oh, yes, that's excellent. Got Yutian sort of hesitating a little bit, and then he's banging the pips. He wasn't doing that earlier. And when you get that knuckleball coming at you, and then you got the topspin on that other side, You're dealing with a couple of balls in. Right now, Lee is on a roll as that scored Yutian 14-3, the last 17 points. Quite a run. Oh, Yutian is completely out of sync. Not only is he getting whipped, he's making high service and lack of focus. And Lee turning it on like a charger. Look at that. Again, another beautiful backhand. Another beautiful backhand, quick right off the bounce. You're really using the pips now. I can see how he's definitely. Look at that forehand. Man. Let's say it's now 17-3 out of the last 20 points. So, as Mr. Lee Poo can play, as he can. Sure didn't look like it through 2.5 games. It looked like he was a 2450 guy. All of a sudden, he's looking like he could threaten 2700. 7-0, folks. You're seeing some pretty darn good Pong. The man in black. Can he keep it going? Oh, just a little bit off that net court. These games to 11, though, you can't relax. You're up 7-0. Next thing you know, it's 8-4 and 9-6. And you got to keep going. You got to keep going. A3, Lee Poo looking to take a 3-2 lead, game five. Dominated game four, and he's dominating game five. Certainly, he's really changed his level. Perfect. Perfect technique. Good serve. Solid deep spin. Counter loop goes long. Look at that. Nice flip there, but waiting for it. Lee Poo takes it right with a big forehand as he wins game four and game five, both 11-3. That's pretty good. Yutian is about a 25-50 player, and he just got spanked 2 games at 11-3. Well, and Lee's a rhythm player, and when the pips are coming in fast and aggressive, then the forehand's working. Usually the forehand on a player like this is going to be a little late, and you can work it, but if he's working you, it's going to go the other way. If he's going quick with the backhand and then picking that forehand up quick off the bounce, you're going to see 2-11-3 games like you just saw. Now, what can Wang do to slow him down? Well, for one, he has to get something better to the attack. The forehand, he's just going slow with everything. And I think he needs to attack the forehand a little bit more. But the way Lee played those last couple of games, I'm not really sure he has the game to handle him here in game six. First prize, $3,000. It's still up in the air for sure. Look at that. Nice drop of serve, perfect backhand opening, and then a forehand follow. I would give him an A on the first shot, and B on the second, and an A on the third shot. 1, 2, 3. Perfect combo. Heavy under. Lee saw it. And took it to the right spot, just didn't get the lift. When you're challenged, folks, and you go to loop, take it to the cross court, the deepest area where you have the most room for error. Don't take it down the line or break its course. Oh. I would say this match went south when Wang just can't receive the serve. He hasn't done anything good on the serve. There's one good one. That serve went off the side of the table, so he's able to lift that up, not push as much as he has been. There's those pips coming off the backhand, folks. It's a tough ball. It's kind of like an underspin ball coming at you. You have to get under it, and you have to be a little patient because it's going to drop short, and you end up whiffing it. Nice loop to the body. There's the big difference there. When Lee goes soft with the pips, very vulnerable. Couldn't be more vulnerable. It's just a little puff ball hanging over the table, but when he goes hard, the reaction time is so short. And you gotta get that racket open. Nice play there by Wang. He's looking a little better now all of a sudden. Three or four excellent points in a row. Match goes back and forth, folks. You can tell they're thinking, changing. Lee looked unbeatable there, but quickly in this game, it's hard to play, you know, three or four great games in a row. Side top, but a nice drop. Big trouble for Wang. Excellent return of serve, set that up. Dead ball serve, good opening. Perfect combo. Dead ball serve, if your opponent doesn't attack it and they push it, it's just an easy ball to get your opening, and you can place it almost anywhere because you don't have to lift anything. You have nothing that's working against you. It's got a nice nothing ball that you can put anywhere. And we could be going seven, folks. We could be going seven, and first two games dominated by Yutian, and then Li Pu since then has really played well. But getting four games, pretty tough. No spin serve. Good return. When you see that no spin serve, you gotta look for it. You should flip it just like that. And if you flip it pretty well, it's the best possible return. Your opponent has not that much time to react. Nice backhand loop there. The pips he tried to cover, but too much energy on that one. Let's take a look at this serve, folks. I think you have a pretty good vantage point. Let me see which one he goes with. Yeah, that one wasn't too bad. That's because he came around the ball. I mean, when you do the pendulum serve, you don't really need to hide it. You can't really, but when you're doing the hook, that's when players use that shoulder to hide that motion, like that one right there. Right there, that little shoulder came in there, and then he didn't see the contact, and he popped it up. Nice. This game's not over. Two beautiful openings by Lee. You have to move those feet, folks, and get those feet set when you loop the ball. You can't always do it, but just strive to do it. Move, get set, loop, Move. Go do another loop. Get set. Side top spin up in the air a little bit. Nice. That second ball, he just went nice and smooth. Instead of going power, he went smooth. Side top again. Nope, side under. Those balls are just so gooey with side spin. It's hard to tell, really. Three-three, Badger semifinal. 217 players playing this weekend, and we're just about halfway through the tournament. They played Friday night. Last night they had the hard bad and the handicap, and they had some corporate team matches. And then this morning they had the 2400s, and then the open singles, and several other rating events. And they certainly have a lot of events tomorrow. They have the 2500, which has a $600 prize. Pretty nice prize for that one. Game 7. I was in one earlier. I can remember everything about it. I was up 3-1, up 4-3, down 5-4, down 8-4, down 9-10, then I missed the last point. All right, game 7, here we go. Li Pu goes with this little side topspin. Nice return by Wang, but give him a 1-2-3-er on there. That was a topspin serve, and he pushed it and popped it up. I bet he goes underspin this time, or dead ball. Underspin. Yep. Another good combo by Li. Good opening, and then he made the opening, and he got in good position so he could hit a hard backhand. That's what you might mean, folks, by getting set. Get that body set, and then you can make the next shot. And then you make the next shot. And down the line, but hits the net. 2-1, 1-2. One timeout. Probably a good timeout. Seems right. You hate to take them when you're down, though. You'd like to get them when you're up, but a lot of times you don't have that choice. Game 7 at the Butterfly Badger Open. Look at that table. So nice and level. And you can have one. It'll last forever. I like the ones that are not rollaways, but I know most people have to get rollaways because they have to put it up and down, but if you can get the ones that sit the 8 legs, man, they're so level and so solid. I love those tables. Li Pu, what should you be thinking about when you're having a timeout? Well, you should definitely be thinking about what you're going to do on the next point, or what serve you'd like to do, or if you're going to be receiving. What do you think might be coming? What are you looking for? And keep your head immersed in the technique of the game. And one, hopefully you'll make good decisions. And two, you won't really be getting so nervous. He goes with the dead ball topspin. Yeah, oh, jeez. Yeah, I could have almost guaranteed it. And Yutian pushes this ball. That's no excuse after a timeout. But it's so easy from the chair and the announcer's booth. But that was clearly side top, and he chickened out and pushed it. 1-5. Nice. Look at that, where he looped that ball right on his right pocket. Li knew he was in trouble and scrambled to try to try to save it, but no hope when they hit you right in that middle slot. Oh. Too bad, returns a serve by Lee, giving Wang a nice big backhand loop. His first real nice aggressive ball. The backhand had been pretty soft there for a while. This could get interesting, folks. 5-3. Up 5-1, but loses 2. Top spin, but he doesn't really reach it. He went to flip it, but didn't quite get up to the ball. It went in the net. Who knows, it might have been under. I could be wrong. Been wrong many times before. Lee up, big point. Let's see which one he's bringing. And long topspin. Look at that. You want to be the champion, you got to take the risk. You serve long, it's a little risky, but a lot of times it's the right call. If it's the right call, you got to do it. Three, seven, two excellent plays by Li Pu there to separate here in game seven. Nice. Oh. Didn't miss by much. Didn't miss by much. That's a big point there. Yutian had a nice opening loop, but Lee on his back foot was able to counter loop it deep. Keep a 4-point edge. We could have our first finalist here. Next semifinal will be up immediately. Both players are warming up. So don't go away. Nice drop shot. Oh, look at the ball placement, folks. Right down the middle. That's a lot of difference between the Chinese players and the American players. Their ball placement is really solid. They get something loose. They're putting it somewhere good. Usually right on the pocket. Going down the line there, a little risky. Never over, folks, never over. Excellent return of serve, which gives him a deserving 5 match points. That return of serve was sweet. It was so soft and low. It looked, that was a tough return of serve, and he did it, made it look easy. Another good one. Look at that. But Yutian, nice soft ball, hits that net cord. 10-6. Lee has to know he has 2 good chances here with the serve. Don't allow it to get to 10-8. Let's see what he does with the first one. Side under. Great block, and it's over. Deserving winner. Deserving. He won game 4 and game 5. 11-3, 11-3. That's a lot of separation, folks.